Hey y'all, and thanks for joining us on another Paranormal Pit Stop. Tonight, we'll be exploring the well-preserved remnants of a historic lumber company town, tucked away on the peninsula that encloses the Arcata and Humboldt Bays, just over the water from Eureka in Humboldt County, California. Widely accepted as the best-preserved company town in the whole of the state, if not in the nation, boasting the last remaining original lumber-style cookhouse in the Pacific Northwest, and purportedly packed with a range of restless spirits, are you prepared to brave the history and hauntings of Samoa? Historically, predating private settlement of the region, the northern spit at the entrance to this bay was utilized in a series of government projects, ranging from the Humboldt Harbor Light, a POW camp for native inhabitants captured through the Bald Hills War, to the Humboldt Bay Life-Saving Station, and several others. Eventually, a non-government settlement known as Brownsville would form, and would derive its name from a prominent local dairy farmer, James Henry Brown, who settled his ranch in 1865 on the site of present-day Samoa, incidentally establishing himself as the first permanent white settler on the northern peninsula of Humboldt Bay. In 1889, a group of wealthy business interests based out of Eureka would establish the Samoa Land and Improvement Company and would purchase 270 acres opposite Eureka. And in 1892, the John Vance Mill and Lumber Company would purchase a sizable chunk of the peninsula for the construction of a large sawmill after an earlier sawmill in Eureka burned. This new mill was finished in 1893. In the same year, the iconic Samoa Cookhouse would open its doors, initially as a place for Vance Lumber Company employees to dine. In 1893, the Eureka and Klamath River Railroad was chartered and would connect the Samoa sawmill with the city of Arcata, while making travel to the timberlands off the Mad River much swifter. In 1894, the Samoa Post Office would open its doors, and in 1900, following its purchase by Andrew B. Hammond, the Samoa sawmill was recognized as the largest in the county. In 1912, Hammond would purchase up surrounding private residences in order to mold Samoa into a company town, and through the 1920s, the Samoa Block Town Center was constructed. In 1956, Georgia Pacific would purchase the Hammond Lumber Company. In 1972, Louisiana Pacific would acquire ownership through a settlement with the Federal Trade Commission. In 1980, mill operations were officially ceased. And in 1997, the old site was purchased by the Simpson Timber Company. In 2001, the property was sold to developer the Samoa Pacific Group, who by 2015 would demolish several structures, while issuing repairs and restructuralizations on others. While the group plans to construct hundreds, if not thousands, of homes and structures on surrounding land, it's all but promised to keep the town's historic core intact. Today, Samoa boasts a population of only 258 residents and is sustained off waves of tourism, mixed with notable haunts such as the Samoa Cookhouse, the Humboldt Bay Maritime Museum, and the Samoa Dunes Recreation Area. Paranormal activity experienced through this old town site and its original structures is theorized to be a result of the restless spirits of former residents, many of whom lived and died calling it their home, with those frequenting the area reporting orbs and strange mists captured in photography, the sensations of being touched, grabbed, or even of being hit by unseen hands, and encounters with both shadowy figures and full-bodied apparitions in old-fashioned clothing. In many of the old industrial buildings, the phantom sounds of machinery and voices long lost to time are commonly heard. Floating lights are often seen bobbing through aged windows, and even skeptics who hold no stake in aspects of the supernatural have described a certain level of discomfort sensed while exploring the bounds of Samoa. One local resident has reported encountering the spectral form of a little girl within their home, time and time again. Some claim this small spirit belongs to a youth who died on the property through the 1960s, and chillingly, she always seems to manifest in the bedroom closet, appearing totally lifelike and able to interact with surrounding objects. Those braving the blacksmith's shop have described extreme hot spots, the disembodied sounds of a hammer heard clinging against an anvil, and the constant feeling of being monitored. And near the historic town center, especially after dark, many have told of encounters with the ghost of an angered, deranged man that's been known to so much as attack those who cross his path. Lastly, in one of the community's many abandoned houses, a mirror is claimed to hold the spirits of its former residents, who supposedly appear behind anyone who stands in front of it. And in another, the ghost of a spectral little girl has been known to manifest to the living, appearing so real she often goes unnoticed, even holding full conversations with those nearby before fading away. Thanks for tuning in for this Paranormal Pit Stop. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.